Hello students, this is Dr. Nirmalanshu here. So today we are going to start a new topic on the chapter States of Matter. And before starting that topic, I want to say that we have discussed some problems from numericals relating to Dalton's law of partial pressure and Graham's law of diffusion in my previous class. Okay. Now the thing is that it is not at all possible for me to solve all the problems in that class. So I have done a few problems relating to that. So now it is your duty to do all the numericals which is whatsoever is there in your NCERT book. And if you find any problem in solving those numericals, you can message me or WhatsApp me. Okay. So before, without wasting any time, we are going to start kinetic, a new topic of this chapter, States of Matter, that is kinetic molecular theory of gases. Okay. Now we have seen that gases obey these gas laws. We have seen that there are some gas laws. Like I want to recapitulate once again. Main fir se dohrana chahta hu. So Boyle's law kya hai? V proportional to 1 by P at constant temperature. V proportional to 1 by P at constant temperature. Okay. Charles law kya hai? Charles law kya tha? V proportional to T at constant pressure. Okay. At constant pressure. Abhi Gay-Lussac law kya hai? P proportional T at constant volume. At constant volume. Abhi this is Avogadro's law kya hai? Volume of gas under similar condition of temperature and pressure is proportional to the number of molecules. So at constant temperature and pressure, at constant temperature and pressure. Then came Dalton's law of partial pressure, that is if there are two mixtures of two or more gases enclosed in a vessel which do not react chemically with each other. Agar do teen gases ka mixture hai jo ki ek vessel mein enclosed kiya hua hai, jo react nahi kar rahe, aapas mein react nahi kar rahe. So what will be the condition? That the total pressure of the vessel will be equal to the summation of the partial pressure of the individual vessels. So that is P total is equal to partial pressure of gas 1 plus partial pressure of gas 2 plus partial pressure of gas 3 plus how many gases are there. So accordingly the P total will be equal to the partial pressure of the individual gases. Okay. So this is Dalton's law of partial pressure. Next आया हमारा Graham's law of diffusion, which is, he says that rate of diffusion is of a gas is inversely proportional to the square root of their density at constant temperature and pressure. At constant temperature and pressure. So these are gas laws, and we have seen that gases obey these laws. So we have seen that gases obey these laws, and for example. Gas can be compressed under if we apply pressure, gases can be compressed. So means that gases are obeying these laws. Okay. Now, why the gases are obeying these gas laws? So to answer this question, we have to study the microscopic behavior of gases. To answer these questions, we have to study the microscopic behavior of gases. Okay. To study that microscopic behavior, a theory has been put forward which is called as kinetic molecular theory of gases, and this theory was developed by not only one scientist, it was developed by various scientists. So all the scientists put together their efforts, they ek hi sath aaya aur un logon ne sabne milke ye theory diya. So this theory was given by, you have heard the name Bernoulli, okay. You have heard the name Joule, then Clausius, Joule, okay. Then Clausius, you have also heard the name, okay. May have heard or may not have heard. Then Maxwell, then Boltzmann, okay. So yes, sir, these scientists put together their efforts to develop a theory which is called kinetic molecular theory of gases, to explain the microscopic behavior of gases. To explain the microscopic behavior of gases. Okay. नाउ ये जो थ्योरी है, इस थ्योरी का कुछ पोस्टुलेट्स है, इस थ्योरी का कुछ पोस्टुलेट्स है. सो द फर्स्ट वन बाय वन वी हैव टू स्टडी ऑल द पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ दिस थ्योरी. सो द फर्स्ट द बेसिक पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ दिस थ्योरी ऑफ दिस काइनेटिक मॉलिक्यूलर थ्योरी इज द फर्स्ट पोस्टुलेट इज एवरी गैस consists of large number of very small particles called molecules. So number one theory is every gas consists of very large number of particles called molecules. Okay. So this is the first theory of first postulate of this kinetic molecular theory of gases. The second postulate is that volume occupied by gas molecules is negligible. The volume of the gas molecules is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. ओके टोटल वॉल्यूम मैं शॉर्टकट में लिख रहा हूँ टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ दी ओके गैस. दिस इज सेकेंड पोस्टुलेट. द थर्ड पोस्टुलेट इज दैट मॉलिक्यूल्स आर इन ए कॉन्स्टेंट स्टेट ऑफ रैंडम मोशन. द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर इन ए कॉन्स्टेंट स्टेट ऑफ रैंडम मोशन. सो मॉलिक्यूल्स एक साथ एक ही जगह में फिक्स नहीं है. मॉलिक्यूल्स यहाँ से ऐसे 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 रैंडमली मूव कर रहा है. दे आर इन कॉन्स्टेंट स्टेट ऑफ random motion, and also if there is random motion is there, so they will collide with each other. So suppose ek molecule hai, ek molecule hai, so ye is taraf ja raha hai, ye is taraf ja raha hai, ye fir se is taraf aa raha hai. So aisa hone se kya hoga, collision hone ka chances hai. So molecules, they are not fixed at any point of space. Okay, so they are constantly colliding, they are constantly in random motion, and as a result, they are constantly collide with each other. So the molecules, the third postulate is that molecules are in a state of random motion, constantly, and they collide with each other. They collide with each other. So this is the third postulate of this kinetic molecular theory of gases. Okay. Now the four as there is collision, so and they collide with each other, and also with the walls of container, Okay. And also with the walls of the container. Okay, so the molecule ये third postulate है. तो चौथा postulate क्या है? चौथा postulate चलो बच्चों देखते हैं. तो students चलो let's see what is the fourth postulate of this kinetic molecular theory of gases. Okay, so fourth postulate क्या है? Fourth postulate है. तो देखो अब third postulate क्या बोल रहा है? Molecules are in a state of constant random motion. And they collide with each other and also with the walls of the container. So, तो collision आ रहा है. तो चौथा postulate है collision के ऊपर. These collisions are perfectly elastic. Okay, these collisions are perfectly elastic. Means elastic मतलब क्या है? That is the molecules will not lose their energy upon collision. Okay, the means that there is no loss of energy upon collision. There is no loss of energy during the collision. But kya hota hai? Suppose ye do molecule collide kar raha hai. Okay, so collision hone ke baad there is no loss of energy. Ye molecule or this molecule or this molecule, there will be, if there is collision, then there will be no loss of energy. Okay. But the molecules will redistribute their energy. So ये molecule उसका energy इसमें दे रहा है, ये molecule इसका energy इससे दे रहा है. Okay? So the molecules, the collisions are perfectly elastic means means that what does it mean? Means that there is no loss of energy. There is no loss of energy during collisions. During collisions. However, they redistribute their energies. They redistribute their energies. Okay. However, they distribute their energies. Okay. So this is the fourth postulate. The fifth postulate of kinetic molecular theory is that there is no interaction between any this molecule. There is no force of attraction or repulsion between the gas molecules. So the fifth postulate is that there is no interaction. There is no interaction between gas molecules. Interaction between gas molecules. Okay. So this is the fifth postulate. There is no interaction between gas molecules. Means there is no force of attraction. I will give you the notes. Okay. This just I am giving no force of attraction or repulsion. So don't mind, my dear students. I will provide you the notes. In my notes, these postulates are so nicely written. But now just now I am giving to have a glimpse of what the kinetic molecular theory of gases is saying. Okay. And the sixth postulate is that, what is the sixth postulate? The pressure, suppose it is the gases are there in this vessel. Suppose this is a vessel. So the pressure to record for a vessel may, the pressure which is recorded is due to continuous bombardment of the molecules with the walls of the container. So molecules ke liye jo pressure. So the sixth postulate may, I am giving it in the form of diagram. So this is the sixth postulate. So sixth postulate kya hai? The pressure jo aa raha hai, sixth postulate kya hai? Suppose this is a vessel. So molecule is moving. So the pressure jo aa raha hai, this is due to continuous bombardment of the molecules on the walls of the container. Continuous bombardment. So this ke liye jo pressure aa raha hai, the pressure which is recorded is due to the continuous bombardment of the molecules on the walls of the container. Okay, the pressure is due to the continuous bombardment of the molecules on the walls of the container. And the seventh postulate is very important. So dekho, molecules random motion mein hai. To random motion mein hone ke liye kya aayega hamare liye, hamare molecule mein kya aayega? Kinetic energy aayega. Okay, that kinetic energy, average kinetic energy is directly proportional. To temperature on Kelvin scale. Means that as the temperature will increase, the collision between the molecules will also increase. What is the result? Kinetic energy will also increase. So the kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature on the absolute scale. Okay. Or absolute temperature in Kelvin scale. Okay. So these are seven postulates of kinetic molecular theory of gases. First thing I want to say that kinetic molecular theory of gas was developed. Why it is developed? Because we seen that the gases obey gas laws. Now why these gases are obeying gas laws? Means the gases are obeying gas laws. How can they say that gases are obeying gas laws? Because gases can be compressed on applying pressure. Okay, gases can be compressed on applying pressure. So why these gases can be these gases obey gas laws. Now the question is why these gases are obeying. So to explain this phenomena, we have to study the microscopic behavior of gases. And to study the microscopic behavior of gases, one theory has been developed by some scientists like Bernoulli, Joule, Clausius, Maxwell and Boltzmann, which is termed as kinetic molecular theory of gases. Now this kinetic molecular theory of gases has got some postulates. It has got some seven postulates. The first postulate is that every gases consist of very large number of particles called molecules. So every gas consists of very large number of small particles called molecules. Okay. The second postulate is that the volume of gas molecule is volume of one gas molecule is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. The volume of one gas molecule is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. Okay. The third postulate is that molecules are not steady at any point of time. Molecules are not at all steady at any point of time. They are in a constant random motion. So constant random motion में आने के लिए क्या होगा? There will be collision between them and also with the walls of the container okay. तो collision हो रहा है, तो collision जो हो रहा है, collisions are perfectly elastic means there is no loss of energy during the collisions. However, the molecules redistribute their energies. Okay. The fifth postulate is that the gas molecules are there, so there is no interaction between the gas molecules. Means there is no force of attraction or repulsion between the gas molecules. There is not at all any interaction between the gas molecules. The sixth postulate is that the pressure which is recorded outside the from the outside of the container is due to the total, it is due to the continuous bombardment of the molecules on the walls of the container. Seventh postulate क्या है? Seventh postulate is that the molecule तो motion में है. मॉलिक्यूल मोशन में आने के लिए उसके पास जो एनर्जी आएगा, एनर्जी उसमें होगा दैट काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द टेम्परेचर ऑन केल्विन स्केल. काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू टी मींस एज द टेम्परेचर एज वी इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ गैस मॉलिक्यूल्स विल इंक्रीज. तो टेम्परेचर जैसे हम बढ़ाएंगे काइनेटिक एनर्जी मॉलिक्यूल का बढ़ेगा. मींस क्या है? ये मॉलिक्यूल्स में रैंडमनेस और ज्यादा आ जाएगा. सो दिस आर सेवन पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ द काइनेटिक मॉलिक्यूलर थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस. ओके, नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव वन इक्वेशन दैट इज कॉल्ड काइनेटिक गैस इक्वेशन. नेक्स्ट वी गोइंग टू डिराइव दैट इक्वेशन विच इज कॉल्ड काइनेटिक गैस इक्वेशन. बट बिफोर गोइंग टू डिराइव दैट इक्वेशन, I want to do another problem relating to Graham's law of diffusion of my previous lecture. So let's do that problem. Okay. So let us do that problem. So that is also a very important question from so far as NCERT point is concerned. So please note it down, my dear students. That is a very very important question. So let's see what the question is and how to approach that question to solve that question. Okay, so before going to derive the kinetic gas equation, we are going to have one more problem, one or two problem regarding Graham's law of diffusion. अच्छा, regarding Graham's law of diffusion के बारे में कुछ problems है. तो एक problem चलो देखते हैं क्या है बच्चों. So question is 80 ml of ammonia gas effuse out from a vessel. Ammonia gas effuse out from a vessel in 8 minutes at minus 5 degree centigrade. Okay. Now, and 500 millimeter mercury pressure. Okay. How long will 40 ml of the FSRT in gas? How long will 40 ml ऑफ ए सर्टेन सर्टेन गैस, सपोज इसका नाम है एक्स, ओके, विथ मॉलिकुलर मास 68, विथ मॉलिकुलर मास 68, विथ मॉलिकुलर मास 68, टेक टू इफ्यूज आउट फ्रॉम द सेम वेसल, टेक टू इफ्यूज आउट फ्रॉम द सेम वेसल, फ्रॉम द सेम वेसल, ओके, एट सेम टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर, एट सेम टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर, ओके, सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन, सो लेट्स गो टू द क्वेश्चन, गो टू द क्वेश्चन वंस अगेन. एक क्वेश्चन क्या बोल रहा है, 80 ml ऑफ एमोनिया गैस इफ्यूज आउट फ्रॉम ए वेसल इन 8 मिनट्स एट -5 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड 500 mmHg प्रेशर. हाउ लॉन्ग विल 40 ml ऑफ ए सर्टेन गैस x, जिसका मॉलिक्यूलर मास है 68, x का नाम नहीं दिया गया है, मॉलिक्यूलर मास दिया गया है 68, टेक टू इफ्यूज आउट फ्रॉम द सेम वेसल एट सेम टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर. सो वॉल्यूम ऑफ एमोनिया कितना है, 80 ml. वॉल्यूम ऑफ एमोनिया कितना है, 80 ml. सो वॉल्यूम ऑफ एमोनिया NH3 इज इक्वल टू, यहाँ पर है 80 ml. ओके, नेक्स्ट दिस वॉल्यूम ऑफ गैस, वॉल्यूम ऑफ गैस x कितना है, 40 ml है, 40 ml है वॉल्यूम. ओके, नाउ रेट ऑफ एमोनिया का डिफ्यूजन का रेट क्या है, सो रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ एमोनिया इज इक्वल टू 80 ml इन 8 मिनट, सो 80 ml डिवाइडेड बाय 8 मिनट इज इक्वल टू 8 tens of, सो 10 ml पर मिनट, 10 ml पर मिनट, ओके. सिमिलरली रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ x का कितना होगा, वेट x का कितना होगा, 40 ml है और टाइम हमको निकालना है, सो टाइम t मिनट है, सो 40 बाय t ml पर मिनट, ओके, 40 बाय t ml पर मिनट, 40 बाय t ml पर मिनट, ओके, सो दिस इज रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ x. अभी क्या है, मोलर मास ऑफ NH3 क्या है, मोलर मास ऑफ NH3, NH3 का मॉलिक्यूलर मास कितना है बच्चों, यस इट इज 17, यस इट इज 17, एंड द मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ x कितना दिया गया है, 68, मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ x इज 68. अकॉर्डिंग टू ग्राहम्स लॉ ऑफ डिफ्यूजन, अकॉर्डिंग टू ग्राहम्स लॉ ऑफ डिफ्यूजन, अकॉर्डिंग टू ग्राहम्स लॉ ऑफ डिफ्यूजन क्या है, रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ एमोनिया RNH3 by RX is equal to molecular mass of X by molecular mass of NH3. ओके, उल्टा ऊपर नीचे हो जाएगा ना, सो इसका मतलब क्या है, 60, इसका मतलब है 68 by 17, इसका मतलब है 2 आएगा, ये 4 होगा, 4 मतलब 2 square जो इक्वल टू 2. नाउ RNH3 क्या है, RNH3 क्या है बच्चों, RNH3 है 10 और RX क्या है, 40 by T, तो T ऊपर चला जाएगा, T by 40 is equal to टाइम हमको निकालना है, is equal to कितना है 2, so T is equal to 10, 4 2 8, सो टाइम कितना आ रहा है हमारा, टाइम इज इक्वल टू 8 मिनट. दिस इज वन अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर NCERT, ओके, अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम NCERT. सो दिस आर सम क्वेश्चन विच आई हैव डन टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स, ओके. तो पीबी के एनआरटी को लेके, डेंसिटी और टेम्परेचर को लेके कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स किए थे, ओके, सो पीबी के एनआरटी को लेके भी कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स किए हैं, So these are some problems which I have done to make you understand how to solve these problems. So I think it will now help you. So with this I want to end up my session here today. So मैं फिर से बोल रहा हूँ my dear students, जो students homework करके मतलब जो students if who are solving the numericals in your at your home yourself, I am very happy with those students. And जो solve नहीं कर रहा है please solve the problems. And if you find any doubts in solving the numericals, then don't hesitate to write to me or WhatsApp me. Okay. So with this, I want to end my session here today. All my best wishes, my dear students. Thank you very much for your patience hearing. Thanks you.